All right, here we go into the game. Columbia University versus Vanderbilt, best of three. This is going to be game one in the best of three. And it's going to be, I think it's going to be a pretty good game. Both of these teams are undefeated at the moment, and we've seen them. AVGL has casted games from both teams as well, and both teams have demonstrated significant skill in while they're playing. So I'm hoping to see a really good game between these two teams. We've got some pretty classic bands, just some meta heroes here, Invoker and Lone Druid, real fast. And it looks like my Yeah, exactly. It looks like my settings need to be... I'm not sure why it's not working. Whatever. Okay. We've got a Sven here banned second here from Columbia Esports. That's pretty interesting. And OD is available, you're right. Death Prophet banned for Vanderbilt, but I'm interested about this Sven ban from Columbia. What do you think about this Sven ban, Cody?
I have to assume it's targeted because I don't think the unit is particularly worthy for space ban.
Yeah, especially when we see meta heroes like Nature's Prophet that's picked very often do very well against the Sven. And see, we do see the OD picked up first from Columbia. It wasn't banned by either team, and Columbia's quick to grab it. Do you think Vanderbilt will respond with the Earth Spirit that is so strong in this patch? Or, I think that would be the strongest option if they had an Earth Spirit player. It looks like they're going to open up with a carry, actually, a Spectre. Spectre Bounty Hunter, very interesting start. This shows a lot of their game plan going into the game, and Spectre alone isn't that great against OD. OD's orbs obviously doing extra damage to illusions, gets rid of that haunt very quickly, and OD doesn't really care too much about Spectre. Bounty Hunter, though, can be annoying for OD. Can be really annoying when the Bounty Hunter comes around to gank, but showing it so early really lets Columbia play around it. Columbia doesn't have to play greedy. Bounty Hunter is really good at punishing greedy lineups, but Columbia can play less greedy because they see this Bounty Hunter. And then Bounty doesn't really get much done as a roaming support if there's nowhere for him to go. And I think picking it this early shows Vanderbilt either really feels confident in their Bounty Hunter and their playstyle, I think, or they just count on the Bounty Hunter a lot in their playstyle to the point where like they'd rather just have it in the first phase rather than chance it being banned out by Columbia. And Columbia is taking quite a while to think about their second pick here. What do you think? Any suggestions on Columbia's side? Oh, didn't need to talk about it. The Faceless Void here. So we got an OD Faceless Void, both of these. We got an offlane and a mid hero. Both these heroes pretty good at contributing to team fight. Looks like Columbia is going to be going for some pretty strong team fight.
That, and I'm not particularly sure Spectre's really going to be weak in lane.
Mm-hmm.
And they're going to need to pick a relatively strong support that wants some fixed.
You're right, and Bounty Hunter is not a strong laning support at all. So
5 seconds remaining.
That's a great point. And I didn't even think about that. Faceless Void is going to have such a great time in that offlane, if it is the offlane Void as I suspected. And we do see Columbia did ban out some strong lane harassers. We see the Lion banned out, and Zeus can be played as a support, also banned out. And Zeus is just really annoying. The constant spam with the lightning bolts, you can't really dodge the damage because it's sort of constant with the time walk.
I believe Lion is a good ban on it because Lion, of course, offers two disables,
yeah,
which are pretty good against Void.
Yeah, and I really like Void's synergy with OD. His Chrono, if placed correctly, can just let OD spam that Arcane Orb for forever, and he gets so much intelligence, and then suddenly drops the hammer, and they're all stuck in that Chronosphere and then just all dead. So I like these two heroes together. I'm interested to see what sort of carry Columbia picks. It sort of rules out a melee carry here for Columbia. So and I do believe a lot of Columbia's favorite heroes are melee in terms of their carry player. So I'm interested to see what carry they're going to pick here. I like Klinks with Void just because of the massive amount of damage. It's just very similar to the OD. What do you think? Any other carries come into mind? Maybe gyrocopter.
I mean, that seems to be the hero if you have
5 seconds remaining.
Just a you need in need of a ranged relatively self-sufficient hero. Gyrocopter seems to be.
We got the Witch Doctor Void combo picked up here from Columbia. This is a pretty straightforward strategy. On the other side, we've got a Beastmaster and a Silencer picked up. So the Silencer is a counter here to this big Wombo combo that Columbia is going to be putting out. The Beastmaster is just a very strong hero in the offlane. And
is the Silencer support? I'm assuming if it is a support, that's a very weak lane.
Actually, Silencer is very, very strong against Void.
Oh, I guess so.
Because this Glaives of Wisdom is just almost impossible to time walk out against. And Silencer actually sort of crushes Void in lane just by himself. So we were talking about the strong lane support. Silencer is that strong lane support. And I think Silencer is a really strong pick.
It looks weak on kind of stun.
It is. It is very weak. They've only got one stun, so
it's an ultimate on a 70-second cooldown.
Yeah, 70 second at level 3. So they're going to be missing out on stuns, and it's going to be pretty hard to gank with the track. So they're not going to be able to get a ball rolling unless they pick a very, very ganking sort of third hero, mid.
The only other stun they have against Witch Doctor is Janotto.
Yeah, and they've all, but they've got global. So
they have global too.
So that's what they're counting on. They're counting on the global. Yeah. I'm concerned about this Bounty Hunter, though, because I don't know if he'll have a great place to go. I'm assuming they're going to be looking to get early track kills with the Roar, but I'm concerned that the Bounty Hunter, who's really reliant on that track gold, isn't going to be able to get out a lot. We've got a Kuro picked up here for Columbia. That's interesting. I'm not sure what this Kuro is about, really. I guess they want to just have more Wombo with the Void, because Kuro has tons of AoE and they're just counting on the Chrono. I don't know. I don't know about this Jakiro. I'm a little confused. And we got a Gyro Band out here, so Vanderbilt doesn't want that self-sufficient range carry, as you said, to be picked up by Columbia. I'm interested to see what they pick last. I am quite partial to Klinks here. I think a Klinks would be strong, although I'm a little curious about this Jakiro pick. He's not really been in the meta whatsoever recently. Yeah, they do have some nice push with the Liquid Fire, and they have some pretty okay synergy with it's not too bad. We got a Viper Band out here from Columbia, and it looks like Winter Wyvern is the last pick, so it's gonna be a mid Beastmaster and offlane Bounty, maybe mid Silencer even. Yeah, I think you're right. This is gonna be a mid Silencer, against an OD. I don't really see. Yeah, I don't see Silencer winning this lane so hard. They can't trade hits, and Arcane Curse kind of sucks dick against OD because he doesn't cast spells. And I guess Last Word is okay, but it doesn't disable anymore.
That
so
also means deployed.
5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, you're right.
Trying to be zoned by Winter Wyvern.
Yeah, Winter Wyvern is still a strong laning hero, but not enough threat like the Silencer where he'll get zoned out. So yes, I do anticipate this Void having a much better time than if the Silencer was
it
a support.
It does, however, give them one other kind of stun too. Mm-hmm.
But I think the Winter Wyvern with the track, it's not, it sort of goes against what you want. The Winter Wyvern wants to have this big ult, big team fight presence where Bounty just wants to get a quick ult, get in, get out, and that's the range here we're talking about, the synergy with the Void. The Gyro was banned out, so they're going to pick up Luna, which I didn't talk about, but I was thinking about it in the back of my mind. That's another one of those range team fighting
heroes. Play large AoE
ult. Yeah. Functions similarly to Gyrocopter. So we're going to do some, as we have a pause here real fast, we're going to do some hero introductions as we go into game 1 out of 3 between Vanderbilt and Columbia. We've got, on the side of Columbia, Will playing the Faceless Void, Calypso on the carry Luna, Cosmos playing a support Witch Doctor, Jesse on the mid OD, and Hanging Sky on this support Jakiro. Would you like to do introductions for Vanderbilt?
We have Karate Man Johnson, the roaming bounty hunter. It looks to be offlane Beastmaster for Hey Look a Bed. I'm Not a Spy is on the Silencer, which we are assuming is going mid.
Mm-hmm.
The carry Spectre is going to be played by Machism XIV.
14?
14.
Yeah.
And Swag Muffins is going to be on the support Winter Wyvern. Alright. We have some bulk chat here. They're trying to get everyone reconnected.
Yeah, it looks like Columbia is going to be taking a quick bathroom break. Let's look at items. Did anyone purchase items yet? No. Looking at the lanes, on this top lane, we talked about in the draft, and we do think Will's going to get a lot out of this top lane. It is going to be Roaming Bounty Hunter, so it will be a dual lane. Spectre, relatively weak hero in lane, and Winter Weaver, not exactly the most threatening of presences because Arctic Burn's cooldown at early levels is just so long. After the first Arctic Burn, Will can just sort of stay in lane for another 50 seconds, and then, I mean, he doesn't really care too much. On this bottom lane, though, we've got tons of kill potential from this deadly tri-lane. We've got the Bongulps, we've got Ice Path, we've got Lucent Beam, and we've got tons of damage. All of these three heroes are ranged heroes, and all of them have incredibly high damage, especially once we're going to see Lunar Blessing. We've looked at these supports. These are some of the most high-damaging supports in the game. Jekyll buffed relatively recently, about a couple months ago. 57 base damage. We've got Witch Doctor, who's been known to be a lane bully with that high base damage. So I'm a little concerned for this Beastmaster. He's going to be summoning boars, but I feel like the boars are just going to die, right? Oh my god, it's not on open mic right now for some reason. No. It's been recording on Twitch, but I don't think it's been recording on. I'll just hold down Z, I guess. It'll be a little annoying. I don't even know if anyone's watching right now in client, so maybe I don't need to.
Oh, yeah. I don't think anyone's watching in client. They can just watch their Twitch bot afterwards.
Exactly.
Maybe move and upload it to YouTube. Yeah, right.
No, we will. I have actually linked my account to YouTube. We will be uploading this to YouTube afterwards.
Feel free to watch afterwards.
Yeah, exactly. So yeah, this offlane is going to be pretty rough for Beastmaster. I don't think Bounty can do really much at all rotating in. And again, these boars are going to be food, actually. They're just going to be continually fed to the supports. Usually, boars are really strong in lane as the offlaner. You get to do a lot of harassing to weak supports who can't really kill it, but these supports are really strong and have a lot of damage to deal with the boars. Mid lane, if it is the silencer, which we did agree it was going to be the silencer, we do think Jesse will be taking the advantage in that mid lane just because Odie is sort of a, you know, strong hero in general. Silencer, his spells don't really counter OD. Silencer's really annoying mid, actually. He's really strong in mid. He's really bullies heroes that are cast dependent.
But OD is just so strong this patch, I can't see.
OD is not cast dependent. The only thing I'm concerned about for the mid OD is the Bounty Hunter. OD, I mean, I guess the Astral Imprisonment, I'm not sure if he still takes the damage from the last word if Silencer casts it. And you can dodge a lot of damage from the Arcane Curse.
He did take Glaives.
I think you want to take Glaives level 1 just to be able to but Silencer isn't played mid much anymore. The reason is because he's really easy to gank. And these two heroes on the side of Columbia are capable of ganking. In fact, they're going to go for this level 1 smoke, and they've got this Lunar Blessing, so they can kill anyone. Let's see if they're going to get caught. Cosmos is going to catch one. There's the Bongos. Will's going to bring up. The Ice Pass is going to catch two. I'm Not a Spot is going to be First Blood, and that's such a great start for Columbia. And that's not looking... That's really bad for the mid-silencer who wanted to have a great time. Crediman Johnson moving up to scout out that all five of Columbia are still hanging out here. And does anyone on Columbia have a Sentry Ward? There is a Sentry Ward on Hanging Sky, so if Crediman Johnson is not careful, they might be able to get this kill on a Bounty Hunter and get a second kill. On the other side, we've got already a ward placed here. I'm not sure if it blocks this camp.
It does not. It's off by a little bit.
So it doesn't block this camp. Just a word for vision, although if there's a D word anywhere, this is like pretty much in the range of wherever you would put your sentry. So I'm not sure about this word. Top rune going to be collected by Jesse, bottom rune collected by I'm Not a Spy, so they're going to be even on this mid lane, apart from the fact that I'm Not a Spy has already died once, but the kill went to Jekiro. So
it's only a 25 XP advantage.
Yeah, it's not a huge deal. Got a ward here, dropped down by Crediman Johnson. Hanging Sky should have seen that be put down. He's got a sentry ready. Is he not gonna? He's got a sentry ready. He should just deward that real fast. Let me pull up some stats here. Last hits denies. Hangy Sky just hanging around this mid lane. Maybe he didn't see the ward be put down. Looks like Jesse already off to a pretty good start. I'm Not a Spy focusing most of his efforts currently on harassing Jesse. Does Crowdman, he has his own sentry here. So he's gonna probably be looking to go into the mid lane, drop a sentry, and then eat that real fast. On the bottom side, it looks like, holy shit, dual offlane Spectre plus Beastmaster, and it looks like it's a dual offlane from Columbia. What the? And Beastmaster is gonna TP up to the top lane. These lanes, I didn't talk about it. I was focused on sort of Bounty Hunter and Jakiro chilling out there, but yeah, these lanes are very interesting, and I think this is going to be favorable towards Vanderbilt. I felt the way the lanes were before was going to be really rough for Vanderbilt if it was a classic lane, but...
Will is still going to be getting a large amount out of
it. Yeah, yeah, Will...
He's going to be solo against the Spectre.
Yeah, but Mankism should be... I mean, he shouldn't be getting much here, but he's getting pretty good farm here. He's in the offlane. I'm really concerned for Vanderbilt because now they're putting their Spectre by herself. She's not going to be having such a great time. They're tri-laning and they're farming their Beastmaster, but they want the Spectre to have that farm. And as you see, yeah, Will is now having a great time in this lane because he's going to have the support of Hanging Sky. Spectre needs to be careful. Yeah, that's going to be, oh my god, 104 damage already. Just a level 1 Jakiro. On the top lane, I missed a kill. Didn't expect the kill to happen, but looks like the slow from Beastmaster and Arctic Burn, along with the Janata Strike, was enough to kill off the Witch Doctor. Winter Wyvern is going to TP to the bottom lane, and looks like Spectre was forced to dagger out as he was getting harassed a lot by this DD rune. And Jesse, quite low on the mid lane, Karate Man Johnson, looking to go around for the backstab, but Jesse's got his bottle completed. Karate Man Johnson just a little bit too slow on that rotation. If he was just a little bit earlier, he might even have been able to snipe the courier. So a little unfortunate for him. And of course, there is this sentry ward in the mid lane that will catch his movement if he tries to make a smoke movement or invis movement. And he's just going to walk through the lane, drop his own sentry, eat that sentry. And now Jesse's got to play very, very careful. But look, Jesse's doing just fine in this mid lane. They're actually tied. 4CS, so actually I'm Not a Spy doing a little better than I thought, but I think as the game progresses it should pan out in the OD's favor.
CS is actually very close across the board, with the notable exception of
Got a support rotating here. Karate Man Johnson gonna move, thinking about going for the Janata, but is there a lot of kill potential? This Winter Wyvern doesn't have any mana whatsoever, and actually, Columbia drops their own ward, and they're just going for it. They're going to do a lot of harass. Swag Muffin's taking a lot of damage here, and oh no, the counter sentry trying to deward Columbia's sentry is going to get instantly tangled up by Columbia. So now this bottom lane is panning out really well for Columbia and Spectre, as we see, not doing so well. Quite a ways behind this Luna, who's not being punished really at all by this Beastmaster. Luna has such high base damage, he doesn't really care about the boar either. See, he's just hunting that boar, trying to get the extra gold. On this lane, looks like I'm Not a Spy taking a lot of damage. There's an Invis rune picked up by Jesse. He doesn't even need it. He's moving up, and actually, he's not even going to chase up. I think if he chased up, he might have been able to get the kill. He's 20 move speed faster than the bounty, than the silencer. I think he could have just moved to the high ground and gotten that kill, but he's playing it a little careful, and now this mid lane is won for Columbia, so they're winning all three lanes now. And things aren't looking too great for Vanderbilt. What does Vanderbilt need to do to come back here, Cody? What do you think?
I'm not particularly sure as of this point. How are the levels of the supports?
Got a level 3 on the Winter Wyvern and a level 3 on the Roaming Bounty. On the other side, we've got level 3 on Jakiro and level 3. So level 3 across the board for supports.
The supports, backspin on the support seems to be divided relatively evenly.
Yeah, I'm surprised the bounty is so high level considering how much he's been moving around the map. And he's going to be looking for a gank here on Jesse. This should be a kill. Jesse is going to pop. Oh, he has an Invis rune and the sentry, not enough range. Barely lives. No! The Orb of Venom gonna tick down Jesse. He should have used that extra bottle charge. He would have lived there. Unfortunate for Jesse, misplayed a little bit there, and punished for it. And now this mid lane is moving towards favor of Vanderbilt just because of that gank there. Although Jesse was having a great time before, so it'll be quite even.
It looks like it's slightly evened out in terms of
execution. Yeah, Karate Man Johnson just been doing so much work this game. He's been rotating all around the map, and he's been managing to get levels here. The issue is, apart from the mid lane, nowhere else is really easily gankable. He's moving down to this bottom lane, but Columbia is the one who's stronger. Look at that. He just gets hit. He takes more damage than anyone on the side of Columbia, and he's actually going back for more, trying to go for Cosmos, but he doesn't have his Janara. What is Karate Man Johnson doing? He's going to fall. Meanwhile, missed the kill on the bottom lane. Looks like that was an ice path, or rather, I don't know. Ice path didn't seem like it was used. It was just the slow from Dual Breath, I guess, and Winter Wyvern out of position. And it looks like Spectre took a lot of damage there too, so things looking really rough for Columbia. And this mid lane, the Sentry Ward is going to be available here for Jesse. So now he's going to be able to farm in this lane just fine. And we look here, he's still doing really well in comparison to the Silencer, as we predicted. Just as virtue, even with the Bounty Hunter being a constant nuisance. But that top lane gank was so poorly executed. I was just praising him. Meanwhile here, hold that thought, we got Bongos, isolated Beastmaster next to his boar, and he's going to die. This Malphite should tick him down. If not, the Lucent Beam will kill him. And Lucent Beam is going to kill him. Yeah, and... We should see a huge gold lead for Columbia. Indeed we do. 3,000 gold already, almost 2,000 EXP lead. The early ganks from Bounty Hunter really only helping out the mid lane, and that's only serving to equalize the matchup. The mid lane is still being dominated by Jesse if we look at the CS. Look at the denies, that's the bigger part. Because if we look at the levels, we've got Jesse half a level ahead of I'm Not a Spy. Bottom lane, we've got some engagement. It looks like Karate Man Johnson rotated in. We got a chrono from Will. Will is going to beat chrono defensively to try to get out of here, but he's going to leave Hanging Sky to fall, and Hanging Sky with the rotation from Beastmare, that's four heroes. This should be a kill. Took a while, but yes, the kill did happen, but that's a four-man rotation to the bottom lane.
However, the kill did go to the person who needed the most.
Yeah.
Spectre is relatively far behind me.
Yeah, oh my god, he is not having a great time
Spectre
at all.
Is actually behind their own offlaner.
Yeah, he's I mean, it's Spectre, it was the offlaner. That was the issue. Like Vanderbilt sort of mind-gamed themselves there. They moved the Spectre to the offlane. They predicted the aggressive dual lane from Columbia, but he wasn't able to farm because the dual lane was just so much stronger from Columbia, and Spectre may fall here to Jakiro. Oh, so close, one more hit. But we looked at top lane did fall, and Eclipso's got his Eclipse. This Silencer needs to be really careful. Eclipso is going to pop the Eclipse. I'm Not a Spy. May fall. Karate Man Johnson actually. Oh, no kills happening on the side of Columbia. One more hit. He's getting slowed by the Orb of Venom. I'm Not a Spy moving back. Nicely juggled here on the side of Vanderbilt. Neither one going to fall. And everyone on the side of Vanderbilt super low moving back. I'm Not a Spy taking a little bit of harass from Creeps, but he should be just fine. There's no Invoker here for Sunstrikes. But oh man, Zeus would be so happy right now if there was a Zeus on the side of Columbia. That would be three kills, I think. Yeah. Oh man, so close. That top lane engagement, that was really risky from Vanderbilt. They knew they were walking into an Eclipse, and I think if the Witch Doctor didn't choose the TP out, if he just stood his ground and fought, I think he missed out on a little bit of damage while he was TPing, and I think that could have been a double kill for the Luna. Witch Doctor was dead no matter what, but could have been a double kill for the Luna if Witch Doctor, I think he had time to right-click two more times rather than TPing. And unfortunately, I'm Not a Spy accidentally... No, I was a farming last word on that creep, man. It's a farming last word. One thing we haven't talked about is the vision. Vision is really in favor of Vanderbilt at this point, and we do expect it to be that case. They've got a bounty hunter who's able to get in behind enemy lines without being punished, and they've got the hawk from Beastmaster, although I don't see any hawks in the field. Yeah, the issue with the aggressive vision, I feel, is that they're playing defensively. Look how far, Columbia doesn't really care that these wards are in the jungle. Meanwhile, Witch Doctor kills mid, and it looks like there was an engagement on this mid lane. Jesse is going to Astro himself, and Mankism needs to be careful. Jesse's going to come out. He's got his Sanity's Eclipse. He's going to use Sanity's Eclipse. I'm Not a Spy. He's going to fall down, and Mankism, he may fall as well. Mankism falls. That's going to be two for nothing on this mid lane. Oh, no. That's actually three for nothing, I think, because earlier Cosmos used his Death Ward to finish off the bounty. So three for nothing on this mid lane gank. It was a three-man gank on the mid lane, and it turned out to be a three-man feed for Vanderbilt.
Voodoo Restoration is a good spell.
Voodoo Restoration is a good spell. It is only level 1. I think they just overestimated the amount of damage underestimated the amount of damage output that a Witch Dark can put out with the Death Ward, and I think they had unfortunate positioning for the Paralyzing Cast. Cosmos has just been on point this game with his Paralyzing Cast. He's been isolating targets away from their Creep Wave to guarantee a nice Paralyzing Cast, and oh, what a nice Chrono. This is a 2-man Chrono. Everyone on the edge. 3-man. Well, the Beastmaster walked into it. He's gonna roar up Will, but Will doesn't care. He's got his time walk, and he's gonna time walk back. Jakiro positioning aggressively, but with the TP coming in from Winter River, and all of Columbia is gonna try to get their way back. Will ticking down, taking a lot of damage. It's gonna fall. Oh, so close. 20 HP. One more tick. Oh, is this long enough? No. He was far enough away, and Will even gonna stop by and get a Midas. I didn't talk about that item. I didn't even see this. This must be pretty recent, but off lane Void. I guess it was safe lane this game, but 3-position Void. He's got a Midas. He's gonna be looking at pretty high. Let's what is net worth? He's the highest net worth in the game. Will is just. We talked about how he would have a good time this game, but we didn't really think he would be dominating this hard. He has more farm than Luna.
The levels on the supports and Vandervos.
Let's look at the levels. Yeah, the levels.
Yeah,
and we look at the level on Witch Doctor. He's actually the second highest level in the game, thanks to that triple kill on the mid lane, right next to the OD, who was also part of that triple kill. But yeah, Will's farming better than Calypso, who's the carry, and Calypso has 2 kills as well. Will only has 1 kill. I guess both of them part of 3 kills. And this game looks pretty much in the bag for Columbia. We do need to worry about the Spectre in the super late game, as I do think Vanderbilt's is really strong into late game, but I think at this point it's just snowballed out. It's snowballing out of control. It looks like Vanderbilt is going to be making a go here on Cosmos. Cosmos is going to get roared up. There's going to be a haunt in to get the kill, but track wasn't available for there, so it was a 3-man rotation here with no track. I guess they do get the nice AoE assist gold, but no track gold there, and that's a lot of commitment. Haunt used, roar used, the rest of Columbia can now posture incredibly aggressively. Look at Jesse, he doesn't care in this mid lane. Now track is available for Columbia, and oh man, they placed the sentry right in range of Jesse's own sentry. Silence, global silence used on the bottom lane. Looks like I'm Not a Spy is trying to get on and triple TP in, but the Chrono is going to be on top. And this nice macro pyre on top of the Chrono, I'm Not a Spy taking a lot of damage. He's still stuck there in the macro pyre thanks to the Winter Wyvern. Oh no, the Winter Wyvern pick count working against them. Will should be able to get out, and looks like Hanging Sky is going to be a casualty on the side of Columbia for that. But we've got a mid lane in exchange for a support. I think Columbia is very happy to take that. Did they get the track off? Oh, nice dust here. They can turn. There is a Death Ward available on this Cosmos, and there's a lot of creeps here that can bounce. Oh, he doesn't go for it. I think that was definitely a kill if he wanted to go for the bongos there. What they have done with that huge rotation bottom to try to save the silencer is focus Columbia down there as well, and now Spectre is going to have a little bit more time to farm, and looks like she gave up on the Radiance completely, going for the Phase Drums Urn build here, just looking to have an early game and stabilize, because if Vanderbilt does manage to stabilize and trade kills, which they've been managing trade kills, perhaps not as efficiently as they'd like, but they have been managing to trade kills, and if they can trade kills with track, they can claw their way back in. We do see 7,500 gold lead, 5,000 EXP lead, so they're quite a ways behind, but with track, they can manage to try to get their way behind. And every time we see Roar's been up, they've been pretty good on using that Roar to just get a quick kill. And the first couple Roar kills, track was not available, but now that track is available, TPing in 3 heroes, that's just fine for Vanderbilt. They're happy with that because they are all going to get that AoE track gold. But they do need to worry about the CS. Columbia is just getting really out of control. We've almost got a Yasha completed on Calypso. He's got his Dominator, and he's starting to stack up these Ancients. Vanderbilt does scout it out, and they're going to ward it. So we may see an engagement happening relatively soon whenever Luna comes down to try to farm these. Vanderbilt may try to stop it. Swagmuffin's seeing Cosmos trying to farm up this stack over here and gonna stop it. So Vanderbilt supports in this top area. Meanwhile, Spectre heading back to base for some reason. He's pretty healthy. He's losing out on farming time right now. Not sure what this is about. He could have farmed.
He picked up his boots.
No, he picked up a drums. He had his phase ready. So I don't know why that was. He's gonna haunt actually. Missed the kill, wasn't paying attention on this top area. He's like, Witch Doctor's gonna fall, but Will's in the area. He's gonna chrono a little early, and he's gonna be trying to go for this kill on Swagman. So with the Ice Path coming in from Chikuro, that is gonna be a return kill, but Vanderbilt's very happy with that. Unless they can't get out. Oh man, the first hit bash from Will, gonna secure another kill. Two for one, but I think Vanderbilt is still okay with that. They did manage to get a track kill onto the Witch Doctor, most importantly, Spectre was in that track kill, and they only lost two supports, so I think Vanderbilt's okay with that. Their supports are the lowest levels in the game anyways. But this is going to open up Columbia to try to make a push on this tier 2. However, the respawns are so short for Vanderbilt. There is a Winter's Curse available for Swagmuffins, and with how strong actually Columbia is right now, they need to be really careful for this Winter's Curse positioning, because if they get a two-man Winter's Curse, three-man Winter's Curse, that whoever is Winter's Curse is going to die. There's just so much physical damage on the side of Columbia. Cosmo's going to get caught out here a little bit on the side. He's going to get slowed by this silencer, but it looks like the engagement happening on the other side. This is going to be a three-man Winter's Curse, and look at Calypso, he's going to fall. That was exactly like I said. A three-man Winter's Curse, and the amount of damage output working on Columbia's side is working against them. Roar gonna go on Will. Is he gonna be able to get out? He is not gonna be able to get a time walk out. However, there's gonna be a ult from Cosmos on the other side, but looks like Mechism gonna be able to Spectral Dagger into the siding. Vanderbilt splitting this fight so well. No one on the side of Vanderbilt falling. Cosmos about to fall as well. Mechism popping out to get this kill. Hanging Sky trying to move in to try to get something for this. And look how deep Jesse is going. Now he's by himself alone. Is he gonna clean up? He's gonna get one kill. Now he's hitting against Karate Man Johnson, but he's getting quite low. He's gonna Astro himself. They need to be careful about standing next to him. No, they're gonna get this kill. This is gonna be a track. Oh, he's got a blink. He's gonna blink out. Oh man, Mechism gonna Spectre Dagger through, and he's gonna get a kill. Oh, he's gonna manage to get the kill. No mana for the track, unfortunately, for the side of Vanderbilt, but they're gonna be very happy with that engagement. That was just so split and well executed from Vanderbilt. They just managed to split up Columbia. It was a 4-for-1.
The only person who survived that fight on Columbia's side was Hanging Sky and Chikuro.
Exactly. That was just so well executed. That Winter's Curse, just as I was talking about, it gets an amazing 4-man's Winter's Curse. Luna dies without being able to do anything thanks to OD's massive damage output working against them. OD getting kited all over the place, not able to lock down damage on anyone. Getting a hammer, it really didn't hit much. I think it hit two people, but they were pretty healthy at that point, so it wasn't as effective of a hammer as they would like. And then Will getting roared right before he wants the time walk. The damage and them able to burst him down during that duration. That was a couple track kills, and this should be a huge dip in the gold. We do see that is going to be 2500 dip. Karate Man Johnson scouting out all of the position of Columbia here too, with the Invis rune here on Winter Wyvern as well. He's got a Winter's Curse coming up soon. If Columbia are too close to each other, they may be able to get another kill. Calypso is just fine though. These two are not going to be able to kill Calypso. If they try to make a go on him, he just eclipses and gets a free double kill. With Hanging Sky in the area too, that's even. Karate Man Johnson looks like he's going to be making a go. Oh, they're just calling for the haunt, but nice ice path into the macro power. Hanging Sky is going to get blown up, but this is a three-man chrono. Unfortunately, Calypso walks in their chrono, but this should be the Spectre. Oh, nice mechanism. Mechanism popped here by the Bounty Hunter, and we've got a roar to disengage, and all of Vanderbilt is going to get out, or are they? Jesse's going to blink in. This is going to be a kill on Mechism. Nice Winter's Curse onto Will, but he's going to be able to time walk off the damage. He actually doesn't even bother using it. But this is going to be a support for the Spectre, even though it was a track kill. This is not favorable for Vanderbilt. I thought they were being way too ambitious with how far they were tracking. It shouldn't be too massive. Yeah, it looks like it's just wiggling a little bit. It's just slightly favored inside of Columbia. But Spectre died. That's what, because he loses gold there. Yeah, exactly. Got nice tracks here coming from Karate Man Johnson. Jesse's gonna blink up to the high ground. No vision for him though. If he did have vision, that was gonna be a kill. If he was carrying a dust, he doesn't have room for the dust, unfortunately. And it looks like Vanderbilt really is playing around this Bounty Hunter so well that. We did see them prioritize the pick in the first phase, and they're playing around it quite well. They're so far behind, but with the Bounty Hunter, they just kept track of Columbia's positions really well and been able to win team fights that they really shouldn't be capable of winning at this point. So kudos to Vanderbilt on that. And the track gold obviously is going to add up, really stopping Columbia from snowballing as far as they would like. We've got another rotation here from Karate Man Johnson. Looks like he's moving in. They're going to spot out Cosmos. He's going to get slowed up here by the silencer, and looks like they're just going to disengage. I'm not sure if that Shadow Walk was seen by Columbia. I guess not, and there's no vision on any of their heroes anyways to do anything about it. If they're paying attention to EXP, I guess they could know, but there's so many heroes in the area that that track will let them know, but there's no detection.
How much damage has Vendabelle managed to get on any of the tier 1 towers? Because I think they're all very healthy.
Yeah. So the tower gold actually
is heavily in Columbia's
face. Yeah, they've got all tier 1s. So
tier 2.
Yeah, so that's going to actually, if Vanderbilt manages to win a huge team fight and take a couple tier 1s, they're actually going to be even in the game. But look at Will's positioning. He's not spotted by anyone. He's going to be able to get a huge chrono here off. He's going to move forward. Only gets a one-man chrono, unfortunately. And now Calypso, again, going to get ulted up by the Winter's Curse. But now he doesn't die instantly, and he's going to get a pop of Eclipse. Fortunately, he's going to die to the follow-up damage. Now the Global comes in with the Haunt. Jesse taking a lot of damage here. Vanderbilt is playing this so well. Grindman Johnson chasing down, but Jesse turns around. Grindman Johnson dies. But on the other end, the Witch Doctor dies, and now Jesse cleaned up by the axes from the Beastmaster. They're gonna keep chasing. Will's gonna fall, and Hanging Sky is gonna fall. This is gonna be a 5-for-1. Only the
5-for-1
Ultra kill for the Spectre. Suddenly, we were talking about how she was unhappy. She's almost got a relic now. Things looking really bad for Columbia at this point. They're not. It should be just down into the. Same, yeah. We look at the fight recap. Oh no, I couldn't click it in time. My broadcasting observing skills are not on point. But Vanderbilt taking these fights so well. It looks like in the lane they're just unfortunate. But the team fights are just so much executed so much better than Columbia. Columbia seems to be a little fragmented about what they want to do, and they're really counting on Will to set up the fights with huge chronospheres, and that one-man chronosphere was just not enough from Will, unfortunately. We do see the three cores on the side of Columbia still are leading in the net worth, but that comes at a price. The Bounty Hunter is making all of Vanderbilt happy with the gold, so they're going to have a more evenly distributed network chart compared to Columbia. And Cosmos, who was having such a great start, suddenly 2-6-9. He actually had this point booster, I want to say like 10 minutes ago, and I was thinking he would have Ags at this point if the game carried on at the same rate it was, but he's nowhere close to his Ags now. He's 3,000 away. And this Bounty Hunter again, just scouting out movement on all of Columbia's heroes, and Columbia not having the sentry placement that they need to be able to pick off this Bounty Hunter. Bounty Hunter even going to move in cheekily to just harass up Calypso. And again, there's still no detection anywhere on the side of Columbia. Flying in a sentry wards for Calypso, but Cryman Johnson even going to steal this Ancient Creep, and he just doesn't care. And they're so mad, they're actually going to chrono here for the Bounty Hunter. That just shows how frustrated they are with the Bounty Hunter, and I do think next game, no matter what happens, they will be probably banning that Bounty Hunter pretty early. Will's gonna TP to this bottom lane. He's quite strong right now. He's got his own Yasha, but probably not gonna be able to kill this really strong.
Interesting, because isn't the normal offline Vestas Void build Vlad's and Deaconyms?
Well, he was doing so well, he wanted to be able to be a damaging core, and Will actually, he's silenced up, he's gonna fall to I'm Not a Spy. Will playing, really underestimating how much damage that I'm Not a Spy as a core silencer can put out, and then of course getting last worded there, he's not able to disjoint the damage. Even if he was, even if the last word duration didn't last as long, there was global available, so that was gonna be a kill no matter what. Will needs to be careful. Yeah, he should have. Yeah, he's got his relic. He's halfway to his Radiance recipe. He should be getting Radiance really soon. And what looked like an almost unlosable position for Columbia in the laning phase is suddenly turning out, because of these disastrous team fights for them, to be a huge win for Vanderbilt. Looks like the Bounty Hunter does get picked off in this mid lane thanks to Rod of Atos from the OD, but I mean the Bounty Hunter is an acceptable sacrifice for Vanderbilt. He's just creating space here. He's tracking all of the movements of the rest of Columbia's heroes so that the important heroes like Spectre, Silencer, and Beastmaster don't get picked off. And they're very happy with sacrificing the Bounty Hunter once or twice to get results. Looks like Will is going to be making a movement, try to kill I'm Not a Spy again. We've got another rotation in from Calypso, and with the two of them, with Chrono almost up, they should be able to get the kill, but I'm Not a Spy sees the rotation from Calypso, is going to just back up. Ward is going to be blocked here. OD gets a solo kill on the mid lane. Missed that. That should not happen. You shouldn't. Why was the Winter Wyvern here? The rest of his team was nowhere close. Why was the Winter Wyvern there? I mean, whatever. It's just the Winter Wyvern, though. That's not gonna ultimately not gonna change much of the game whatsoever. Yeah, he's got a blink. He's got a blink available, and it looks like they spot out. They're gonna use another Chrono here, just for Karate Man Johnson. They're really, really giving him hate. They just. Using the Chrono on Karate Man Johnson, they identified the true reason why they're losing these team fights, and they're just expending everything to get rid of, the Bounty Hunter. But all of this effort is gonna give Spectre room, and she's picked up the Radiance. She's really farmed at this point. It looks like, are they gonna be looking to take a Roche here with Bounty Hunter dead? Looks like they thought about it and then decided against it. It looked like I'm interested to see when Will is going to get his Ag Scepter, because these Chronos for bounties are quite expensive at this point. But if he does go for the Ag Scepter relatively soon, he can actually just use the Chrono on the bounty every time. The bounty, if he's down for like 30 seconds, I mean, that's basically you've only expended a 30 second cooldown on the Chrono, and you're able to take objectives, for example, that tier 2 that they just took because the bounty died. That's very worth it. It's a little expensive, though, at this point with no ags. I guess they're very happy to use it anyways if it does lead to objective, but it does result in them not being able to fight for quite a while as they are so dependent on that Chronosphere. And one thing I didn't talk about in the fights, actually, is I'm Not a Spy's global timing. It's been very on point. The global timing has just really stopped Columbia's aggression in its tracks. The fight is initiated by like the Winter Wyvern, and then the global comes in and prevents Columbia from actually making a turnaround. And then that was how Vanderbilt was winning a lot of their fights. All thanks, actually, to the Bounty Hunter's tracks. But all of them, actually, the whole Vanderbilt team is working together nicely, and the vision from Vanderbilt is just paying off. Look, we've got the Hawk Vision, Bounty Hunter, Will is going to fall, and then we got a Roar on the other side from Jesse, Spectre is going to come in, and that's going to be two quick kills for nothing. Cosmos and Hengi Sky came in, and Hengi Sky actually had his Yule Scepter, so he may live. Will's going to TP in, this gets a four-man Chrono, actually double buybacks here from Will and Calypso, and they're going to get a bunch of return kills. That's going to be a 4-for-3, but that costs two buybacks here. Looks like I'm Not a Spy is going to be able to get out. Jesse, not fast enough with the Blink Astro. They won't be able to deny up the tower, but that was track gold on Vanderbilt's side and two buybacks. Yeah, it wasn't even a win for Columbia. Columbia had to expend two buybacks. They are going to get the Roche, however, and probably a tier 2. So overall, the net worth change should be in favor of Columbia slightly. But that was really nasty. They really wanted to get like that. They had to expend two buybacks. Yeah, you give it to the OD for sure. Calypso's just been he's got his BKB now, so he's not gonna be able to be blown up quite as easily anymore. A lot of Vanderbilt's damage is still magical. The OD is the one they need to be careful. OD is Columbia's major damage output at this point. Yeah, the BKB timings are pretty important here for Columbia. They're going to be looking to make a push once OD gets his BKB, and Aegis still has around 1.5 to 2 minutes left. I think that's what Columbia is looking for. Once OD gets his BKB, he should still have Aegis for a little bit longer. Meanwhile, it looks like Cosmos is going to be getting picked off here. I'm Not a Spy, got a Boots of Travel, going to Boots of Travel in. Cosmos getting picked off, but nice blink in from Jesse, going to get a turnaround. Will is going to get ulted by Swag Muffins, but there's only one person hitting him, and it's only Hanging Sky. Jesse going to move forward, going to Astro up the silencer, and their haunt comes in from Machism, but Jesse's got Aegis, he doesn't care. I'm not a spy, solo, but he's getting move speed from Chak, gonna be able to get away. Nice two-man chrono on the side from Will, but Hanging Sky does fall, and it looks like the Witch Doctor died there. Calypso gonna come in, gets a BKB off, and I'm not a spy, slowed up by the Yule Scepter, or by the Atos, gonna Yule's himself, but he will fall in the end. Gets the Global Silence off before he dies, but it's gonna be a 2-for-2, but that's Chak gold. Two supports for Korra and a Winter Wyvern, but that's track gold. Makism needs to be careful. He's going to get Atos up. He actually Spectro Daggers in. He'll be okay, and there is support here, but Roar was used earlier. I didn't talk about Aether Lens build here on the Beastmaster.
Very interesting.
Yeah, it does extend Roar range, but I feel like just Ags, Blink Ags. Necrobook. Yeah, but
I've never seen a Aether Lens use.
Aetherlens first Beastmaster, yeah. But now that he's got Blink, he's really scary because Aetherlens does increase your Blink range as well. So he's gonna be able to get amazing roars off with the Blink range on the Aetherlens. Karate Man Johnson picking up his own Aetherlens, and he's actually got a Guardian Grief, so he's such a force in these team fights. He's gonna be able to get tracks from so far away. Oh, the haste rune on Jesse. He's gonna slow up Makism, and he's gonna get the kill with the Astro. That Spectre getting picked off here, but they need to be a little careful. No, Winter's Curse is not available, and a two-man ice path here from Hanging Sky. Roar's gonna go on Jesse. He's gonna start taking a little bit of damage. He needs to Astro himself. He's gonna Astro himself, but he probably will fall. All of Vanderbilt waiting on the sidelines. Jesse's actually gonna be able to get a TP blink out. Is he gonna fall? He's getting healed from Witch Doctor. Oh, the Splinter Blast is gonna finish him off, but Will slowing up everyone, and we've got Calypso coming in with the Eclipse. He's gonna get an Eclipse off. Eclipse is gonna finish off the Winter Wyvern and the Bounty Hunter, so it's gonna be a 4-for-1 trade here. Now with that kill, Clumpia is gonna be able to look to push high ground. What is this Silencer gonna be able to do? I don't think Silencer should be able to do anything with Chronos still available on Will. Are there buybacks on the side of Vanderbilt? They're gonna need a buyback if they wanna hold this tower. What is the hotkey for buyback? Buybacks are available, but only... no buybacks are available. The only buyback is available for the one who's dying right now, and he gets bashed up by Will. Chrono is going to be expended. Buyback just available for the Bounty Hunter, and the stun's going to come up. I'm Not a Spy should fall here. No, he's got to get a clutch Guardian Greaves here, and the respawn coming in from the Spectre. He's going to haunt in, and now Columbia's extended way too far. That's going to be one kill, quick kill on the... Witch Doctor, and it looks like Jakiro's gonna try to make his way out. He's TPing out. They've got a track on him, but neither one of them actually gets killed. Both of them TPing out. They're taking advantage of Vanderbilt's lack of stuns. And it looked like Shuriken Toss was just not on cooldown because both of them were tracked up. He could have canceled both TPs if he managed to get a Shuriken Toss off. He does have an Aether Lens, so I think it was just off or just on cooldown because otherwise he would have just Shuriken Toss for the easy double kill. So Columbia only lose one for that aggression, and they did get a lot of damage on the racks, but that wasn't really what they hoped for. They did get a buyback, though, buyback on the Bounty Hunter. Clips on this bottom lane, looking to make a go on I'm Not a Spy. I'm Not a Spy should be able to get out. He's really quite fast with that Boots of Travel. Yeah, according to, I don't think the stream picked you up, but Cody, looking up the stats here, according to DatDota, in a professional game, Aetherlens was never picked up on Beastmaster, so we're seeing some next level builds from Hey Look a Bed. And I really think Aetherlens isn't really that necessary. It extends your Primal Roar by a little bit, I think you really prioritize the Blink over the Aetherlens, and then once you get the Ag Scepter, the Aetherlens is really negligible. It's very similar to how you don't really need to get Aetherlens on a Sand King once you got the Sand King Axe. It's pretty much the same situation there. Top lane, it looks like Vanderbilt is going to be looking to make a go on the two supports. Instantly a TP in from Will, and they're going to try to make a counter rotation. There's going to be another TP in from Calypso. Will's going to be able to move forward. He's going to time walk forward, and he's got a chrono available, but it's not in range of the Beastmaster, and all Vanderbilt is going to be make a quick retreat with the track there onto Will, giving them move speed, and they should be able to get out just fine. Will actually first item Manta style, so he's looking to be a damaging core. I think Will needs to focus more here on control. I think he really needs to get that Ags up and running because Columbia has been winning their team fights off of the Chronos, I feel. either able to isolate someone and kill them instantly, or just stop the rest of Vanderbilt from protecting one of their players when someone else is going on. So
Lopez
I
has recently become towards his axe.
Yeah, yeah, he just got his point boosted. Oh, Bleak forward from Hanging Sky, gonna get the Yules, and this is gonna be a nice ice path, but the silence comes in from the silencer. Jesse gonna blink in. This looks like a pretty decent fight for Columbia. Winter's Curse gonna cancel off a lot of Calypso's damage. Spectre going ham on the supports, but we got two heroes on the side of Columbia. Oh no, it looks like actually Vanderbilt has managed to split the attention of Columbia long enough, but Spectre does fall in the end. Will lives with 8 HP, and Hanging Sky is going to be able to blink his way out. And without Spectre, their major damage output, Vanderbilt may not be able to fight. But Calypso, sort of miscommunication here on the side of Columbia. He's going to fall, and then Jesse falls as well. It looks like Calypso was like, Spectre's down, we should fight. Everyone come back. But Will's like, I've got 10 HP, I can't fight. And Hanging Sky's like, I blinked out, I can't fight. And so Calypso going back in, and then OD, listening to Calypso, goes back in, and they feed two kills that they didn't really need to feed. I think that would have been very favorable if they just traded the Witch Doctor for the Spectre, and then everyone got out. Yeah, so very unfortunate communication here on the side of Columbia. That was really unnecessary, two deaths. But Vanderbilt shouldn't be able to do too much here. Will's going to be able to just monta off the silence and get out. And actually a nice Jakiro ult here, getting a lot of damage, but Hanging Sky's just taking so much damage from I'm Not a Spy. I'm Not a Spy, actually. Look how much damage output he's putting out. Oh man, they're going to get quick double kill here from I'm Not a Sky. Both of those track kills, I do believe. And I think this might be starting to dip down finally for the first time in the whole game to Vanderbilt's side. Maybe just a little bit more after this tower, it should definitely dip down. I think it's strong on Bounty Hunter. In pro games, but I think it's pretty good. It's really common in pub games. Calypso needs to be careful. He's gonna TP in. He actually gets another TP in from Jesse. Jesse's gonna be able to move forward. It doesn't manage to get the hit off onto the Beastmaster, and Spectre gonna TP Haunt in. He's gonna be able to do a lot of damage. Jesse isolated on his own. Calypso isolated on his own. Calypso is gonna pop the PKP, pops the Eclipse, but there's so many creeps here. Calypso's not gonna be able to get much done. Both heroes picking up their PKBs, but they're stuck here. They're not gonna be able to do so much, and they're getting kited. Oh no, they didn't manage to kill off the Beastmaster. Beastmaster gets away. Now Calypso gonna get chased down by the Winter River, and Hanging Sky Yules is up the Spectre. Gonna save his carry, but he's gonna fall in return, and this could be the beginning of the end. And this Beastmaster's still alive thanks to that Guardian Greaves. This Guardian Greaves doing so much work on the side of Vanderbilt. The Guardian Greaves giving that armor and HP regen, and that's gonna force a buyback already from the OD. And again, yeah, this the communication on the side of Columbia just hasn't been on point.
It has completely, repeated buybacks have completely destroyed his item progression and his power.
Yeah, and we got a Chrono here, solo Chrono on the Spectre, and right at the edge, Jesse's not in range. He's gonna use his Astro to try to stop it, but a nice roar from, hey, look at that, and looks like Spectre's gonna try to actually turn around. There's gonna drop the hammer, but it doesn't get any kills, and looks like Columbia just wanna disengage, or do they? Jesse's gonna blink back in, kill off the Beastmaster, and looks like Makism's gonna just TP out. And buyback expended just to defend the Rax, and they only get a Beastmaster kill. Columbia is definitely not happy with the result of that. One thing we haven't talked about is how farmed Calypso has been. He's been getting so much farm this game, but he's been just getting kited so hard. Every time he pops his BKB, Winter Riven just drops the curse on him, and it looks like Vanderbilt don't even care if the curse does damage. They just want to be able to remove Calypso from the fight, while Spectre, every time she'll just haunt and then instantly jaunt to the back lines and pick off the Witch Doctor and the Jakiro, and then that is a lot of Columbia's control, and then the global silence really putting a hurt on Will, and that's probably why he got the Manta style first there. He wants to be able to take off the silence so he can get the Chrono.
Witch Doctor recently picked up a
Axe. Alright, so we did see the Witch Doctor Axe picked up, but it's really hard to get a ult off. They've got Janata. I guess Roar isn't really going to be used, but they've got the Global Silence, and he's almost always going to wait for the Global. And I guess they've got Winter's Curse.
I don't know what Winter's Curse is. The Winter's Curse is Discourse and Aurora are valuable because they penetrate BKB.
Yeah, they're going to be used on the cores. And it looks like Swagmuffin's out of position again. I think this Winter Wyvern is by far the weakest player on Manor Build. He's probably significantly lower in MMR. He's just been getting caught this entire game in positions where he really shouldn't be. He did get that really nice Winter's Curse on four people, but his positioning has been quite questionable for a lot of the game, and this should lead to a free Roshan for Columbia. Yeah, Haunt's up. The rest of Manor Build is making their way in. Haunt's gonna get used. Bounty Hunter steals the Aegis. Oh, they actually stole the kill. Oh my god. And the Chrono actually keeping everyone inside. What a horrible Chrono. It actually completely stopped Columbia from doing anything. And there may be able to get a kill on a Bounty Hunter. Are they even be able to do it? The Guardian Greaves doing so much damage. They are gonna get killed, but he actually picked up the Aegis. And Hanging Sky, that's the ultra kill for Spectre, and Columbia didn't even get the Rosh. They didn't get the kill, they didn't get the Aegis, completely stopped thanks to that Hawk vision, I do believe, from the Beastmaster. And the vision from the Hawk and the timing and the plays from Vanderbilt have just been so good this game. Columbia has just not been on point. Individually, perhaps, they're more skilled, as we did see their dominating lane performance, but as a team, they're just not as coordinated as Vanderbilt. Vanderbilt's just been stomping Columbia in these team fights, and that's where it counts.
We saw that the fight at top lane, and they decided to re-engage with half their team.
Yeah. So there's been some communication issues, whereas Vanderbilt's pretty much been on the same point. Maybe Winter Wyvern gets caught out once or twice because of bad positioning, but in team fights, he's been playing pretty well. I don't think he's made any significant mistakes in team fights whatsoever. Now with the Blink Dagger, Aether Lens picked up on Winter Wyvern. Everyone on the side of Vanderbilt building Blink Aether Lens. Blink Aether Lens on Bounty, Blink Aether Lens on the Beastmaster, Blink Aether Lens on Winter Wyvern. Their initiation range is out of this world. And now Will's going to be TPing forward, looking to get a Chrono. He actually doesn't have the Chrono up. He still doesn't have his Aghanim Scepter. And I think Columbia has to go all in at this point. They're so far behind. Look at the gold lead. They were leading, and now they're 20k gold behind, 14k EXP. They can't actually afford. They can't win the fights anymore. And it looks like they're gonna get caught. Or who's getting caught? Swagmuffins get caught here. But nice roar here from Lookabed. Gonna stop the aggression. But a two-man Chrono here from Jesse. Gonna pick off the Bounty Hunter. With that Bounty Hunter down, the Guardian Greaves no longer available. Winter's Curse used solely on the Jesse. Global Silence pop. And the Spectre actually going to move forward to try to kill off Jesse, but Jesse's on the other end. He's popped the BKB. He may be able to live. On the other end, though, I'm Not a Spy just cleaning up. Jesse falling. Jesse's going to go down on the side. Calypso doesn't even manage to get a solo kill. He does manage to get the kill with that Lucent Beam, finally on that Silencer. But Silencer managed to kill three people with the help of the Winter Wyvern. And now Spectre's coming in. Big bad Spectre, who's got his heart, coming in for the kill. Calypso waiting for his TP, gonna TP back, he should be fine, but it's a 4 for 3 with really good initiation from Columbia. They managed to waste two big ults on the side of Vanderbilt controlling Jesse without anyone damaging Jesse during that. Both the Roar and the Winter's Curse were used on Jesse, and no one was damaging during that entire time. They managed to get a nice two-man Chrono, instantly pick off the Bounty Hunter, so he wasn't able to contribute to the fight, and still they lose just because of how farmed Vanderbilt are from those team fights. And things really aren't looking great for Columbia. I think they can still win, but they just have to out-teamfight Vanderbilt. And so far, Vanderbilt's just shown that they're the better team in terms of teamfight. And Columbia's just...
I mean, Columbia's draft, as always, does have that amazing wombo potential. Yeah, so... the five-man Chrono into the Death Ward, into the Eclipse, and Chikiro.
But I don't think that'll ever happen.
That's a very long shot with the way that Vanderbilt's been playing.
Yeah, Vanderbilt should never let that happen. Why? Because they have Blink Aether Lens on three heroes. There's absolutely no reason for Vanderbilt to be that clumped within the range of a Chronosphere, because their initiation range with Blink Aether Lens on Winter Wyvern is like, what, 2,000 units. That's a 2,000 unit initiative. On Beastmaster, he's got his Axe Scepter as well. So he's like a 2,000 unit initiation range. So we've got two 2,000 unit initiations. They've got Bounty Hunter who can track from like 3,000 units away. Spectre's always there with Haunt, so that's a global, obviously. And then the Silencer's just really tanky and stolen quite a bit of intelligence. 50 intelligence stolen on the Silencer. Silencer just puts out the damage, so Columbia can't kill the Silencer. We saw in the last fight, they tried and they lost 3 before they could pick off the Silencer, which allowed the Spectre actually to not even focus on any hero. Spectre, the entirety of the fight, he actually pops the Haunt, just the Scout. He's gonna actually go in. This is interesting. There's gonna be a TP forward, booster trial forward from Beastmaster. They're gonna get a roar onto Jesse. Nice chrono onto Spectre, but the Winter's Curse goes onto the Witch Doctor. Witch Doctor's gonna fall. Eclipso's in the middle of everyone with his Eclipse, but he's by himself. He pops the Satanic, but he's not gonna be able to get enough from that. And Will taking a lot of damage, gonna be a buyback from the Luna, but Will's gonna fall as well. Where did Jesse go? Jesse managed to blink his way out, and that's a buyback from the Luna popped already. We have no buybacks on the rest of Columbia, so this is gonna be extremely hard hold for Columbia. And I think this is the game. I don't think they can. Yeah, I don't think they can do much. This Silencer is so rich. 58 intelligence stone, he's got a moon shard, he's working towards, I don't even know what this Reaver is about, just a Reaver to tank up. And look at Jesse, he can't even do anything. They've Atosed him up, forced the self astro, and he's just gotta blink out. He can't do anything at all. They're just stalling here, trying to stall out for Will to respawn and get the chrono off. And we've just haven't seen Columbia able to pull off anything big. Chronyman Johnson blinking forward to try to get his item from the base. And the evasion actually from the Heaven's Halberd working, but he dies. That was ambitious. He's playing a little cocky here, but I think it's okay. The Silencer is putting out more damage with his nukes than the OD. We finally see a big death ward, but it doesn't get that much. And the rest of Columbia is going to be looking to chase. Spectre looking to re-engage. I'm Not a Spy turns around, doing more damage than Calypso here. Calypso doesn't have his Satanic, and I'm Not a Spy. Is he going to win? Oh no, Calypso does win that man fight. And now he's going to turn around and try to fight Makism, but Makism is much stronger. Makism kills off Calypso, and now it's 4v2 here with the buyback TP in from the Beastmaster, but he gets caught at the edge of the chrono. Actually, no, he's not in the chrono. He was barely out of the chrono. Is going to be able to get the roar on to Jesse. Jesse actually manages to astro himself. Is he going to be able to blink out? He should be able to blink out. He is going to blink forward, be able to blink away, but it looks like, hey, look a bad. Is going to maybe be able to catch him off. He's going to blink forward. Another astro from Jesse. Bottom lane, though, the Mega Creep's taken by the Spectre, and finally Jesse falls, and this should be GG called out from Columbia. Indeed, Tangy Sky is going to call GG, and Vanderbilt is going to take game one. It was looking bad for them at the beginning of the game, and I was calling it a Columbia win, and then they just somehow pulled out the most amazing team fights, and with Bounty Hunter, obviously, if you can team fight with a Bounty Hunter, you're back in the game, and obviously Spectre into the late game, just such a force to be reckoned with. But the Silencer was so strong in those team fights, able to man fight this Luna, who really shouldn't be able to man fight a Luna with BKB as a Silencer.